cold there. Alrighty, just got back from a semi-annual enterprise QBR in Vancouver. Never been to Vancouver. Fantastic place. If you ever have the chance to go, I would highly recommend it. But man, was it really, really cold. So good to be back in Florida. The weather is so much more to my liking, which means I don't need to be wearing this outfit anymore. Much better. All right, guys, how to Tuesday. So for this week, I'm gonna switch gears a little bit. The last couple weeks, we've been focusing on the endpoint protection product and certain features and functionality within it. For example, last week we did application control. If you missed it, I'll put it up here on the card. You guys can go back and watch that one. I think the week before that we did update management, and the week before that we did peripheral control. So you can find all these videos on our YouTube channel. They're all there. I think the only feature that we haven't talked about yet in the endpoint product is the web control feature. We'll probably get to that in a couple weeks, but we thought shifting gears right now to a new product was pertinent. So we're gonna talk about Sophos Phish Threat for probably the next couple weeks. I'm probably gonna turn this into a five-part, maybe six-part series. It's that important of a product. It's that important of something that all, it's that important that all companies should be doing it. And we know not enough are, so we wanted to take some time and spend a good chunk on this product for you guys. So part one of this series, however long it ends up being, for Sophos Phish Threat is gonna focus on the dashboard and setting it up. It doesn't take nearly as long as you're gonna see Brandon doing the video. We're trying to take our time for everybody so you guys have a very good feel for how this thing functions and how easy it is to set it up. That way, when you do it yourself, it goes like that. All right, on to Brandon.
So here we have the Phish Threat dashboard. On the dashboard, you can see straight at the top, I'm showing two of my four active campaigns. If I'd like to see all, I have the see all option here. It drops me straight down in the campaign section where I can see all four of my active campaigns plus my past campaigns. We go back to the dashboard. The next section is the organization summary. So this gives you a report on comp to open ratio versus report to open ratio based on the last five campaigns. Now, if you're testing your users as frequently as humanly possible, or I should say as frequently as you should be, typically we recommend at least once a month, if possible. Worst case, once a quarter at least. In this case, with the organization summary, you can see my caught to open ratio is 29%, which is fair. Report to open ratio is 12%. Some room to work there, but that's kind of the whole point of this is the more campaigns you launch, the better users get, the more suspicious they become, the higher you'll see these numbers get, or I should say lower you'll see this number get and higher you'll see this number get. Next section is caught users and threat reporters. Again, you can click see report and it'll drop you down a report so you can view the entire information. Just from kind of a global stance, it's showing you your top five caught users and your top five threat reporters. Next section is the awareness factor. So this is how you as an IT organization are doing training your users. So based on a total 100% count of the users that I have installed on this system, 76% of them have been tested, should be 100%. Last campaign was launched 22 hours ago, which is excellent. The more frequent, the better. 45% of the users have been caught, and 39% of them have actually passed their training. So again, some ground to work on, but that's the whole point. Next thing that I like to pop into is the settings section to do the initial setup. So you've just gotten Phish Threat, what do you do? First thing I'm gonna do is choose, do I want to add my users via Active Directory Sync? So if I want to do AD Sync, I can go ahead and do that through here. You click AD Sync, download the AD Sync installer, set the settings on the Active Directory server, and it'll import your users and your user groups. The second option is to actually go into People, click Add, and you have the ability to import via CSV. And then the third and final option is to actually add each user individually. Obviously, that can be pretty laborious in large organizations. If we go back into settings, the next step is to go ahead and get the report message add-in button for Outlook. Now, what this will do is this will actually put a button in the top right side of their Outlook application on their desktop or in their OWA web app. You can actually add this into most mobile phones, a whole number of different things. You can download the XML manifest right here. Any instructions or anything you need, just click learn more, and you can follow through all of this to get the instructions on your specific system and how to add it in and what's compatible with what and that type of deal. Let's go ahead and pop back in here and go back into settings. The final setup is the sending domains and IPs. Now, we are sending targeted phishing emails. And yes, this is training, but to an email security system, it's going to look no different as it should. So the first thing that you're going to want to do is come in here, and you're going to want to whitelist these two IPs. Now, depending upon how strict your email security is within your organization, you may need to go a step further and actually whitelist the domains that we use to send phishing emails from.
So this is like it's like a problem. Every city we go to, we have to collect these Starbucks mugs, and we don't even use half of them. We have an entire cabinet full of mugs. I think I've been used one time. It's like an addiction. It's a problem. So there you go. Setting up Phish Threat, the dashboard, super simple. Want to get this out there for everyone so you guys can see just how easy it is to get this set up. The faster you can get it set up, faster you can start rolling out campaigns and attacking folks, and the faster you can start training people, and the faster you can get everyone's security hygiene up. So with that, keep in mind, all of our content makes its way to our YouTube channel. We would love if you subscribe. We've got a lot of other content there that we've been releasing throughout the last couple weeks and months. Feedback is huge. Thank you for everyone that's providing it. It really does mean a lot to us. It helps make these videos better, and we're gonna keep doing these because we're having a ton of fun. And I think that's it. So thanks again, everyone, for watching. We'll see you again on another How To Tuesday.